Nobody wrote these words that I'm saying. It was all a matter of fact. Life isn't always like a movie. You can't walk out and get your money back. I'm not sure I believe that you and me were brought together by a twist of fate. I'm gonna love you like nobody loves you anyway.
Growing up in Katy, Texas, it's definitely a little different than Hollywood. At my roots, I'm just a Texas girl. I was always like the one on the coffee table and always the one trying to put on a show and always the one saying, look at what I can do. The only thing we really had available in Katy, Texas was like rodeo beauty pageants. And so that's pretty much where I got started. I just literally started signing up for anything that would allow me to be on a stage with a mic entertaining people, which led me to winning Star Search 5 times and to Branson, Missouri. I did 2 shows a day, 6, 7 days a week from the time I was like 11 to 15. And so I quit for a few years and I just wanted to be a normal kid. Well, I was really, really bad at that. The textbook definition of a troubled teenager. When I didn't have music and I didn't have performing and I didn't have that release, I really didn't know who to be. It took me quite a few years to kind of figure out that me and music had to have a relationship for a lifetime. Then this little show called American Idol came along. Then literally the day that I got booted off the show, I got a job with Fox Sports and then TV Guide Network and then MTV and then CBS throughout the years as a host and as a correspondent. And it was something that just kind of like fell in my lap. It was something I never knew I would make a career out of. It was just taking up way too much time for me to actually take this wholeheartedly seriously. I didn't want to wake up wondering what if. And so I had to just put everything aside and quit my job. And regardless of the repercussions, I knew that I had to give this 100%. So I started writing and recording, and I took all of my music and demos to Vanguard and Capitol Records, and they got it. It's not okay treating me this way. I'd rather let you break my heart and live. I've been on a stage most of my life. There was nothing more special and more surreal than kind of the first day going into the studio to record my album, finally, after over 20 years. So my album, Without Regret, I think really is all about empowerment and is all about being able to stand on your own 2 feet and just being able to rise up whenever you might fall. Being in the studio with the live band when they were playing the songs that are gonna go on my album and then also the songs that I had written. You know, hearing them come to life was one of the most memorable moments from this whole experience. I have 5 little sisters, believe it or not, and I try to be a good role model on most days. And I think that the single Desperate Girls and Stupid Boys, the message behind it is really great. It's about, you know, putting your energy into things that are really positive and making sure that you don't waste your time and your effort on things or people that don't deserve it. And knowing that, you know, life is a lot easier and just a little bit brighter when you just stop trying so hard.
Kiss tomorrow goodbye. This is gonna be a late night. Get up and let it go. We've got the
It's, you know, exciting but overwhelming. And it's really hard work, but every second has been so memorable. And at the end of the day, I'm just, you know, the girl from Katy, Texas.